You're listening to Radio New Vegas, your little jukebox in the Mojave Wasteland. I am Mr. New Vegas, and I'm here for you. More news for you. Sad news from Good Springs. The town was wiped out after heavy fighting with a gang of escaped convicts. Travelers are advised to keep their distance. Also, unconfirmed reports say NCR's General Lee Oliver may have uprooted from his post at Camp McCarran in order to be present at Hoover Dam. NCR sources say that holding the dam against Caesar's Legion has become their main strategic priority, and this move would not be unexpected. Boy, the Mojave Wasteland is just a fascinating place, isn't it? You never know what's gonna happen next. More classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
To the town of Albreel rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip, big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his head. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead.
Better be careful around these parts. I hear there's powder gangers around and dangerous for merchants like me.
And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 and 19 more.
Well, you see, I... Fuck. I'm really a bounty hunter trying to catch some powder gangers. But they probably saw through me just like you did. I've been hanging around hoping to ambush some of them, but haven't had any success. No, but there ought to be. I'm just taking the initiative, is all. Not a whole gang or anything, just two, maybe three. I was a caravan guard, so I know how to handle a gun pretty well.
Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw
you know, just filling up water and stuff. Huh? Didn't know there were women powder gangers. Oh well, the NCR will still give me a nice bounty for your corpse. We'll see about that. I'm hit!
It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red had not cleared leather, for a bullet fairly ripped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
Never gets old when something blows up. You eyeballing me?
Damn, running low on smokes again.
Never gets old when something blows up.
Any lawman that comes after me won't have it easy.
I've been thinking that since you've been good to us, we can be good to you. We've got plenty of spare powder and dynamite around. Say the word and we can give you some of it every couple days. We're out at the moment. Come back later. Good. Had him figured for NCR, one of the Rangers maybe. Anyway, speaking of the NCR, I need you to take a walk down to Prim. The NCR hasn't raised hell over our breakout, and I want to find out why. They're up to something, I can feel it. I know the NCR has troops near Prim, so talk to the locals and find out if any of those troops are going to be coming our way. Yeah, get out of here.